safest, a new home. Hello and welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are new, I'm Sherry, and I had gastric bypass June 1st. I'm about 5.5 months post-op, and this is part two of things I wish I had known before I had gastric bypass. So, this video is going to be a bit TMI. I'm going to spill all the tea, all the details. Maybe some of them you wish you wouldn't know afterwards, but I'm going to tell you anyway. Number one, you are probably going to deal with diarrhea and constipation. Do not, I repeat, do not ever trust a fart after surgery. You will regret it. Trust me. And I know this is not just me. I've heard lots of, not heard, read lots of people on my bariatric group have commented and said that they have soiled their underwear because they trusted a fart. Don't do it. Number two, actually, no, not number two. More about constipation. If you go more than 1 or 2 days without going to the bathroom, just spare yourself the pain and drink some smooth move tea or take a laxative. Don't let yourself go more than 2 days, because if you do, you'll regret that. You will be in so much pain and you will be on the toilet thinking you are dying. It is not fun. Number two, on a more fun note. So, moms, if you have children nearby, you might want to cover their ears. I am going to be talking about intimacy. So I will give you a couple seconds to pause the video or shoo them out of the room or cover their ears. Okay, you back? Great. All right, intimacy. It is going to get so much better. Like I knew that losing weight would probably help, but I didn't know. Ladies and guys, when we gain a bunch of weight, we end up with this big padding in our nether regions, for lack of a better term, and it affects our sex lives. You don't have as much sensation, you can't get as close to your partner, and it just doesn't feel as good as it could. When you lose the weight, surprise! It's like a whole new world has opened up. It feels better, it's easier, you just have more energy, and so all around, intimacy just gets better. Number three, more TMI, is gas. You are going to have the worst smelling farts and burps after surgery. And your family is going to dread when you eat things that give you gas, like beans and broccoli and things like that, because they're going to know what's coming. And you know what? You don't even have to eat gas-inducing foods to have gas after gastric bypass. Like, it just happens. Number four, pain. I was not expecting to be in so much pain after surgery. Like, I thought losing weight would help my pain, but it really hasn't. I would say my pain has probably gotten worse, and that's not just my story. I've heard that from several people who have lost a large amount of weight, that their pain has gotten worse. For instance, now my legs hurt. I have no idea why, but like my lower calves just like hurt all the time. They ache. I don't know if that means that I'm low on electrolytes or what, but I've been dealing with that. My hips hurt when I walk. Like I feel like an old woman. When I stand up, I'm like so stiff now. Your tailbone is going to hurt when you sit for extended periods of time. When I sit in the bathtub, it hurts. my back, my upper back, my lower back, my middle back, they have all been hurting. I'm guessing it's because I've been losing the cushion that's between the vertebrae and they're just kind of rubbing together now. I don't know. I'm hoping maybe by next year, my body will get used to the new normal and maybe I won't be in so much pain anymore. Number five, the weight is not just going to fall off. As much as I would love that to be the truth, it's not. This whole journey has not been as easy as I thought it was going to be. I thought I was going to get the surgery, just concentrate on eating protein, and the weight would fall off. Yeah, that hasn't been the case. I've actually really been having a tough time, and I've been having to really work at it, and it's still been slow. Everybody's journey will be different, and that's just mine. And it's okay if you're a slow loser. At least it's still coming off, right? So I've been having to try to cut down on carbs. I've been tracking my food again. Like before, I wasn't tracking because I thought, hey, if I'm concentrating on protein and trying to stay around the 200 calorie mark per meal, that I'll be all right. Not so much. So I've started tracking my food again, and I've upped my protein again, because protein, your body has to work harder to break it down. So your body actually burns calories while it's absorbing the protein. So I've been doing that. I've upped my exercise and trying to get the scale moving again. Number six, your hormones can go crazy after surgery. My periods have been crazy and I've been having weird bleeding. And my hormones have really been affecting my weight loss. When I ovulate, my body's been holding onto water more than it used to. And so the week that I ovulate, I haven't been losing weight for the last few months on the week that I ovulate. Same thing for my period. The week before and the week of my period, I either gain weight or stay the same because of water weight and hormones. It has been so frustrating, but that's my journey. It might happen to you, it might not. Guys, you don't have periods. You are so lucky that you will not have to deal with that. But girls, it's a very likely possibility that your hormones could go crazy for a while. They will level out eventually. A lot of people actually get this surgery because they want to have babies. So it does make you more fertile. So your hormones will level out eventually. And once they do, then you should have an easier time getting pregnant if that's what you want. Number seven, my final point. People will say you look great, but you will still feel fat. Body dysmorphia is a real thing. I always thought it was ridiculous when I would see people commenting in my bariatric group on Facebook saying, oh, you know, I've lost all this weight, but I still feel fat. I still feel like I weigh 300 pounds. I still feel like I wear a size 26. I always thought that was really weird because it's like looking at them, it's like, you're obviously skinny now. What's your problem? Get a grip. But now that I've lost 56 pounds, I still feel fat. Like, I still feel like people are looking at me and thinking that I'm the fat girl, or people are thinking I'm lazy. I still feel unattractive. But like just last night, my husband called me a skinny mini. I was like, no, I'm not. I still have so much to lose and the scale has barely been moving lately. He's like, yeah, you are. And then he sent me a couple pictures of me working out last night. Apparently my baby had been, I was stretching and my baby came and was sitting next to me on my yoga mat and she was stretching with me. And he took some pictures of us. I didn't know he was taking pictures. And he sent them to me. And yeah, like the pictures that he sent me don't line up with the image I have of myself in my head. Like, I still think of myself as being big. So maybe I mean, I would really love to get down to a size 6. Like, that is my ultimate goal. I just want to wear a size 6. It's what I've wanted, like, my whole life. Maybe when I finally get there, because I'm going to get there, I'm going to push and do whatever I have to do to get there. But maybe once I get there, my actual image and how I see myself in my head will line up. But until then, I just got to keep working on my head and working on my body and stay positive. Trust the process. Just because you stall doesn't mean you're done losing weight. I know it doesn't mean I'm done losing weight. Weight loss is not linear. It looks like this. Unfortunately. Wouldn't it be nice if it just weren't? But it doesn't. You have times where you barely lose. You have times where you hardly lose anything at all. Like nothing. And then you have times where it just drops like that. So I'm hoping that I have a time period like that coming up soon where it just goes like this. Because I've been working hard the last few days, but I'm not really seeing much payoff. But I know it's coming. I know it's coming. I'm just waiting for my hormones to calm down. Anyway, guys, that's all I have for you, and I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys. A new place, a new home.